events were about to take a much different course. In 1957, the Soviet Union shocked the world by launching Sputnik, the world's first satellite. The space race had begun. American pride was injured, and the need to catch up became a driving political force. Within a year of Sputnik, NACA disappeared. Langley, the other NACA centers, and four military facilities were merged to form NASA, the National Aeronautics and Space Administration, whose priority would be to make America first in the race for space. Langley Lab became the NASA Langley Research Center, the cornerstone of the space effort, with the creation of the Space Task Group and Project Mercury. The arrival of the seven Mercury astronauts thrust Langley into the national spotlight.
I believe that this nation should commit itself to achieving the goal, before this decade is out, of landing a man on the moon and returning him safely to the Earth. No single space project in this period will be more impressive to mankind or more important for the long-range exploration of space.
It was a daring gamble. The prestige of a nation had been entrusted to Langley's Space Task Group. The Mercury program was the first step. In 1961, astronaut Alan Shepard was the first American in space, making a suborbital flight of 15 minutes. In 1962, John Glenn was the first American to orbit the Earth. Mercury demonstrated that men could be launched into space and safely returned. The space effort demanded a myriad of experiments. The nation needed a launch vehicle to carry small payloads into space. The Wallops experience with rockets, tracking, and data acquisition helped Langley create Scout. The Scout team launched the first of a long and successful series in 1961. After the Space Task Group left for Houston in 1962, Langley Resources remained committed to space. In the Rendezvous docking simulator, full-scale models of the Gemini spacecraft hung from the rafters of the West Area hangar. Gemini astronauts flew the vehicles to rehearse and perfect their docking skills. Likewise, in the Lunar Landing Research Facility, Apollo astronauts felt the impact of firing thruster rockets in a simulated 1/6 gravity and maneuvered in the harsh light of a simulated lunar landscape. Langley's Lunar Orbiter project was designed to map the moon to find landing sites for Apollo crews. The first of five lunar orbiters was ready for flight a mere 28 months after the contract was signed, and all five were in orbit within 14 months of the first launch. The orbiter's cameras took pictures of the moon, processed the film on board, and sent the resulting images to Earth.
It was extraordinary to believe at the time when we started that we would be successful in firing five spacecraft to the moon and have every one of them be a success. To that degree, the program was extraordinary.
Roger, here, you're weaving your way up the freeway.
Contact light. Tranquility Base here.
On July 20th, 1969, Neil Armstrong took those first fateful steps on the surface of another world. As Langley researchers watched the first lunar landing, they could remember that the manned space effort all started on the site of a former Virginia plantation.